Bruchim Aboyim, thank you for coming. Tonight our lecture will be the 18th lecture on the our series in Gematrias. And we're dealing with actually two numbers. We're going to deal with the number 16 and then 70, and we'll discuss as to why that's the case. So again, this week we'll be discussing the number 16, Shisha Asar, which is 6 plus 10. There are those who do not spell the number 16 as Shisha Asar, but what they do is, again, with a Yud and a Vav, which are 10 and 6, but they spell the number Tet and Vav, which is really 9 and 7. There's a reason being, they do this because both the Yud and the Vav are two of the four letters of God's name of mercy. So that we do not pronounce, so as not to use them in a denigrating way. We use the Tet and the Zion. Oh, I put down Vav, excuse me. Tet and the Zion is really what it is to make it 16. And that's how we get to that number. Now, we really do not find the number 16 mentioned often in the Torah. There are some places that we see it. For example, there were 16 sacrifices that were offered on the altar on Yom Kippur. The high priest would sprinkle the blood of the sacrifices 16 times on the inside of the heichal toward the curtain that separated the holy from the holy of holies. Again, all of this is on Yom Kippur. He would also sprinkle 16 times on the outside on the copper altar, the Mizbeach HaNechoshet. Now, the word kaper, meaning atonement, is mentioned 16 times in the parsha, in the portion of Acharei Mot. There are 16 faces of the angels that are called the holy chayot, the holy, it's like wild animals, that's a word. Also, when we combine all the kadeshim that we recite each day during the evening, morning, and afternoon prayers, they total 16. Now, there is a Kabbalistic belief that when a mourner, someone who has lost someone dear to them, leads the services, he can benefit the soul of his deceased family member by reciting the Kaddish. Now, each Kaddish has the power to protect the soul of the deceased for 1.5 hours. So the 16 Kaddishim throughout the day protect a person's deceased soul for 24 hours. And that's the reason why people try to lead the services to be able to say all of them. As we have mentioned before, God's name of mercy, the Yud-Kei Vav-Kei, is hidden within the letter Tet. Now, the letter Tet is made up of a Chaf and a Vav. Again, 20 plus 6, which is the numerical value of the God's name of mercy, the Yud-Kei Vav-Kei. And when we add a Zion, again, making it to 16, it equals 26 and 7 is 33, which is the numerical value of the word HaKoach, the strength or power. So the spelling of 16 with a Tet and a Zion alludes to the connecting to the power and the strength of God. Now the number 16 also alludes to the creation of the world. As we know, for 6 days God created the universe, and on the seventh day that he rested. So you have 16, 1 and 6, and refrained from creating. Again, it's not that God needed to rest. He just stopped creating. We refer to God as our Father in heaven. The word Av Echad, one Father, in Ivrit has, again, a gematria of 16. Now, that's really basically what I've found more or less for the number 16, and it wasn't a great deal. But the 16th letter in the Hebrew alphabet, again, there are 22 letters, is an ayin. Now, an ayin has a numerical value of 70, so the rest of the lecture will be on the ayin, on the number 70, again, which this comes to. Now, the letter ayin is the letter of perception and insight. Its name, ayin, means eye. Now, the organ of sight reveals more to man than any other of the four senses. As the rabbis tell us, ein adoma shmia l'riya, that hearing something cannot be comparable to seeing something. The Mechilton Shemot states, again, the Medrash states there, that there are 248 organs in the human body, and their movements are directed by the eyes. The eyes are the windows of the brain and also the windows of the soul. Now, according to the Malbim. Now, the spiritual nature of the eye can readily be seen in that it is the only organ in the body that resists being touched by anything physical. The right eye is looking up at the sky and the left eye looking down at the earth. Spiritually, the right eye looks up to God and the left eye looks down favorably at all Jews. The word ayin also means fountain, alluding to the fact that that's the place from which tears flow. The ayin's design is actually two eyes united at the optical chiasma. That's the nerve center that receives and interprets visual impulses at the back of the head. This gives us a new understanding of the positioning of the mitzvah of tefillin. The Torah tells us that the head tefillin should be the totefos b'nei necha, between your eyes. Now, the proper positioning of the head tefillin is slightly above the hairline, atop the soft part of the skull. Viewed from above, this spot, soft spot, is literally at the midpoint between one's eyes and the chiasma. So based on this, the head tefillin is set directly between the physical eyes of the body and the eye of the brain, just as the Torah prescribes. Now, man is called an olam katon, a miniature world. According to Shmuel HaKotan, so is the eye of man a microcosm of the universe. The eye is the world. The white represents the ocean. The iris, the land. The pupil, Yerushalayim, Jerusalem. The image of the observer in the innermost center is the temple. The Sfas Emes explains that man's purpose on earth is to transform the physical covering in which his soul has been encased into the light of Torah knowledge and mitzvah fulfillment. Now, the number 70 relates to the particulars that make up a whole. The Maral of Prague writes that the number 7 represents the entirety of this natural world, which was created in 7 days and which will last for 7,000 years. Now, any number times 10 represents its expanded full potential, so that 70 of something represents all the potential facets of that thing in the natural world. The average human lifespan is associated with the number 70, as it states in Tehillim, chapter 90, verse number 10. The days of our years are 70 years. This was stated by David HaMelech, King David, who lived exactly 70 years. And as it's mentioned in Pirkei Avot, chapter 5, Mishnah 24, reaching the age of 70 is considered to have attained the fullness of age. There are also 70 words in the Kiddush. In the Shema Yisrael that we say every day, the ayin is large of the word Shema. This alludes to the message that the eye sees, the mouth speaks, and the ear hears the words of God. The Talmud tells us that summa kemes, that a blind person is considered as if he is dead. And the name Amalek can be broken up into Ayin Malech. That the Ayin, again, the number 70, that the Ayin, 70 nations of the world, want to Malech cut off our heads, much like a priest who cuts off the head of the bird as a sacrifice from the back of the neck with his nail. Again, not something that we think would be pleasant. Also, the gematria of the words Gog and Magog, which allude to the final battle between good and evil before the coming of Mashiach, the gematria of Gog and Magog is 70. The word Yayin and the word Sod both have a numerical value of 70. The word Yayin means wine, and Sod is secrets. The Gemara in Erevin states, page 65a, that when wine goes in, the secrets come out. On a simple level, this means that wine loosens one's tongue. However, on a much deeper level, sod, secrets, symbolizes the concealed innermost essence of the Jewish nation, which is rooted in the unchanging divine morality that is immune to the shifting human fashions. Yayin, wine, depicts the inner qualities of the grape, a product that is greater than the grape from which it originated. Now, when do we take wine? We take wine every time we want to ascend from one spiritual level to the next. We take wine as we enter the Shabbat in order to elevate ourselves to the level that Shabbat provides. We also take wine at the end of the Shabbat because we want to ascend from the Shabbat to the next week at a higher level than the previous week. We take wine at a circumcision, at a Brit Milah, in order to ascend from this mitzvah to the covenant, to the treaty between God and the nation of Israel. There are said to be 7 distinctive qualities within a human being. The many dimensions of the divine revelation within the infinite Word of God are expressed as the 70 faces of the Torah. These are compared to the 70 facets of a diamond, of a jewel. There are multifaceted layers of depth within each and every letter and word of the Torah. There are 70 words in Psalm 20 and Tehillim. The Gra, the Vilna Gaon, states that they correspond to the 70 years of travails and suffering, referred to as the birth pangs of Mashiach, that the Jewish nation will have to experience before the Messiah comes and redeems us. There are also, these also connect to the 70 cries of a woman in labor. There, Rizal says that this psalm has 9 verses corresponding to the 9 months of pregnancy. Now, the highest judicial authority in Israel is called the Sanhedrin, the High Supreme Court. This court consisted of 70 elders. They were called the Ayin Ha'eda, the eyes of the community. The precedent for this court was set in the desert, where Moshe Rabbeinu, Moses, our teacher, assembled 70 elders together. An allusion of these elders was the 70 date palms in Elam, found by the children of Israel in their travels in the desert. These 70 elders were expected to be fluent in all 70 languages. If the court sentenced one person to be put to death once every 70 years, Talmud called it a killing court. The generation of dispersion was divided into 70 nations who spoke 70 distinct languages. Each nation's unique identity and distinguishing features have their parallel in their corresponding 70 administering angels that are in the spiritual and heavenly realm. Now, during the first temple era, the Jewish nation was exiled from Eretz Yisrael, from Israel, for 70 years due to the non-observance of 70 Shemitah cycles. The land remained fallow and in a state of desolation during that 70-year period. Israel's precarious existence among her enemies is compared to the miraculous survival of one lone sheep surrounded by 70 ravenous wolves. In the story of Purim, Haman ruled for only 70 days, and Esther and Mordechai and the people of Shushan fasted for 3 days before Esther went to see Ahasuerus. She fasted for 70 hours. There are 70 days of the year that maintain a special holiness, 52 Shabbosim and 18 Chagim, holidays. On the holiday of Sukkot, 70 oxen were offered on the altar. These 70 oxen represent the 70 nations of the world. In fact, it has been stated that if the nations of the world understood just how much benefit they received from these sacrifices, they themselves would have stationed guards around the temple and would have not allowed it to be destroyed. In the Pesach Haggadah, Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah begins his opening address with the words, "Ani kaven shivim shana," I am like 70 years old. Terach, Avram Avinu, Abraham's father, was 70 years old when he was born. Avram was 70 years old when God spoke to him at the Brit Bein Havsarim, the covenant between the parts. When Yaakov came down to Egypt with his family, there were exactly 70 souls that came with him. These 70 souls are connected to the 70 nations of the world. When he died, the Egyptians mourned for him for 70 days. At the giving of the Torah on Mount Sinai, the divine word of God was split into 70 languages and was heard throughout the whole world. When the Jewish nation crossed into the Holy Land, They wrote the Torah onto 70 stones in the 70 languages in order that it be accessible to the members of every nation. The Torah is referred to as the Septuagint, which in Latin means 70. This is alluding to the 70 elders who translated the Torah into Greek, which was the first translation of the Torah from Hebrew into any other language, by King Ptolemy II. And miraculously, all of them that made changes into what the Hebrew language said so that it would not be misinterpreted. And even though he had put them all in separate rooms, each one made exactly the same changes, miraculously. Again, we see the greatness of God. There are 70 names of God, 70 names of Israel, 70 names of Torah, 70 names to Jerusalem, and 70 pillars that were built in the temple. All these parts come together in a whole and unified state. So 70 plus 16, the two numbers that we've dealt with tonight, have a numerical value of 86, which is the numerical value of the name of God, Elohim. Bereshis Bara Elohim, the name that God used to create the world. And on the seventh day, he rested. May he bring Mashiach quickly and in its time. Again, thank you for coming. God bless and have a good Shabbos.